Halftime at the Wrangler National Finals Rodeo presented by Polaris Ranger. Five rounds down, five rounds still to go. I thought round number five was kind of a breakout round for some guys. Tough Cooper, we're not going to see him in the highlights here, but he's put a little more heat now on Trevor Brazil in that all-around race.
Yeah, Tough did what he really needs to do. He's making a move, and you know, now we have five rounds left. It's going to be a fight just like we expect.
Yeah, and you're kind of banging that Rogers and Petska drum.
Boy,
we'll get to that in just a minute. How about Mason Clements, Wrangler NFR rookie? He was the bareback winner, 88.5 points.
Yeah, I'm not surprised to see Mason win this round. I mean, I expect him to win rounds. I watched him all summer long. He is a talent.
Yeah, he's got a lot of skills, and shining at his first Wrangler NFR, Tanner Milan, the big Canadian. He's now won two out of five rounds in steer wrestling.
Boy, last guy out of the box, and he made a super run. Knew he had a good steer, but he still took advantage of it. A
couple of teams at the top of the average stumbled, so Rogers and Petska split the win, and they moved to the top spot in that average race.
Yeah, that's a huge move for these guys if they expect to win a world title. Of course, they had to kind of share the spotlight with two former world champions, Clay Trine and Jade Corkle. About time those guys struck.
Saddle Bronc Riding, Sterling Crawley gets the spotlight all to himself. 89 points. He's the winner.
On a former Bucking Horse of the Year, I was really glad to see Sterling make this ride. This is a great matchup. Excellent.
Marty Yates starting to find his stride in the tie-down roping. He plays big in round number four. He wins round number five.
You know, Marty knew he had a good cap. He was the first guy out in the event. That's a lot of pressure to go come right back and make that run, and he sure did.
Co-champs in barrel racing, and if you're a barrel racing fan, you got to be a fan of Louie and Lisa Lockhart.
Yeah, everybody here was cheering when Louie made this run. She was first out of the alley. Of course, the advantage is always a little more for the first girl, and Louie looked like they were going to win all by themselves, but things changed.
Yeah, Ivy Conrado came roaring out. She also had a time of 13:59, so we had co-champs in the barrel racing.
You know, she's riding a little horse she calls J-Lo, and I'm telling you, this horse is getting faster and faster every performance. I expect her to win another one.
And on the bull riding side of things, how about the guy that's number one in the world? He's won the last three world championships. He was the last to go, and that's a perfect stage for Sage Kimsey.
That day off for Sage Kimsey to get on a bull like this. It's fun to watch him ride. He is simply amazing.
Put it in cruise control, and he is the go-around winner. And how about the Ram Top Gun standings? Keep in mind, whoever wins the most money in the single event gets a brand new Ram truck. Right now, it's Haley Kinsel, who also set an arena record a little bit earlier in the week with a run of 13-11. Trey Benton bucked off tonight, but he's been on a great roll as well. Pre-show comes your way tomorrow night, 9:30 Eastern time, and it rolls us right on into round number six of the Wrangler NFR. We're ready now for the second half.